Good evening, everybody. I'm in Philadelphia, where our Constitution was drafted and signed. It wasn't a perfect document. It allowed for the inhumanity of slavery and failed to guarantee women, and even men who didn't own property, the right to participate in the political process. But embedded in this document was a North Star that would guide future generations. Through civil war and bitter struggles, we improved this Constitution to include the voices of those who'd once been left out. And gradually, we made this country more just and more equal and more free. But at this moment, this president and those who enable him have shown they don't believe in these things. I understand why a lot of Americans are down on government. I understand why a white factory worker who's seen his wages cut might feel like the government no longer looks out for him, and why a black mom might feel like it never looked out for her at all. I understand why a new immigrant might look around this country and wonder whether there's still a place for him here. Why a young person might look at politics right now, the circus of it all, the meanness and the lies and conspiracy theories, and think, what is the point? Well, here's the point. This president, those who benefit from keeping things the way they are counting on your cynicism. They're hoping to make it as hard as possible for you to vote and to convince you that your vote does not matter. That is how they win. That's how the economy will keep getting skewed to the wealthy. How our health systems will let more people fall through the cracks. That's how a democracy withers until it's no democracy at all. What we do echoes through generations. We are all the children of Americans who fought the good fight. Great-grandparents working in fire traps and sweatshops without rights or representation. Farmers losing their dreams to dust. Irish and Italians and Asians and Latinos told, go back where you come from. Jews and Catholics, Muslims and Sikhs made to feel suspect for the way they worshiped. Black Americans spit on for trying to sit at lunch counters, beaten for trying to vote. They knew how far the daily reality of America strayed from the men. And yet, instead of giving up, they said, somehow, some way, we are going to bring those words in our founding documents to life. I have seen that same spirit rising these past few years. Folks of every age and background who packed city centers and airports and rural roads so that families wouldn't be separated, so that another classroom wouldn't get shot up, so that our kids won't grow up on an uninhabitable planet. Americans of all races joining together to declare that Black lives matter, no more, but no less, so that no child in this country feels the continuing sting of racism. To the young people who led us this summer, telling us we need to be better, in so many ways, you are this country's dreams fulfilled. You can give our democracy new meaning. You can take it to a better place. But any chance of success depends entirely on the outcome of this election. This administration has shown it will tear our democracy down if that's what it takes for them to win. So we have to get busy building it up by voting like never before so that we leave no doubt about what this country that we love stands for. Stay safe. God bless.